1, 2, 3, 4. On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends. And I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again. Going places that I've never been. Seeing things that I may never see again. And I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again.
Episode of Dingo's Diaries. This time we're on our way to Nullan Homestead, which is a station out near the town of Kew, about 8 hours, 7.5 hours northeast of Perth. It's kind of in the Gascoyne area, beginning of the Pilbara. Now, we were supposed to be in Cairns right now, having a wonderful holiday up in the north of Queensland. But because of COVID and our poor vaccination rollout and a few other things, which I'm not going to go into right now, that's another story, our Cairns trip got cancelled. So we decided to test out the old Subaru. This is his first camping trip. And head into the outback. Perth has been, it's winter time. And we've had a huge amount of rain and thunderstorms and just band after band of rain coming through the city. So it's too cold to go down south. So we decided to, we haven't been north very much, or not inland anyway, sort of the beginning of the Pilbara area, and check it out. As it turns out, my dear friends Bob and Lynette, who has a house in Pinjarra south of Perth, and I've known Bob since I was a high school student, his wife, or former wife, she passed away a few years ago and was my high school teacher. And so it turns out that Bob and Lynette are going to be in Kew as well, but at a station that belongs to some friends from the Naturalist Club. They're going to be at a place about 5 kilometers south of Kew. Nullan Station, where we were going, or are going, is 5 kilometers north of Kew. So we're going to rendezvous with them there tonight. We took a bit of a wrong turn. We're listening to a book on tape and missed a turn off. So that was about 50 Ks. Put us off. And we were heading out of town. Got about 15 kilometers out of Perth, and I realized I'd actually forgotten to strap the tent to the roof of the car. So we had to turn around to go get the tent. But don't tell anybody. That was a little embarrassing. But anyway, we're now on the road. I think we're on the right turnoff, heading towards Kew. So we probably won't get in there till about 5, 5.30. We've got about another 3.5 hours to go. Weather's clearing up, haven't had any rain. They've had rain out here. You can see the water everywhere. But should be a pretty good trip. Hoping we get to see some nice stars. It's going to be cold at night, but warm during the day. The Subi is doing really well. It's packed to the gills. It was really hard trying to get all the stuff I had in the Nissan Navara into a Forester. And it was a lot of fiddling around trying to get stuff to fit on the roof rack, trying to get everything packed in the back, but you'll see what I mean later. Anyway, I think we're on the right track. Thanks for joining us for Dingo's Diaries, and hope you enjoy this trip with us. Believe it. Hey guys, quiet. At night we're trying to sleep, okay? Do you have to keep going all night? I don't get it. Thank you. That's all. See? You just gotta know how to talk to these guys. Stop. So this morning we're going to drive through the station, and this road that comes through the middle of it goes for, I don't know, hundreds of kilometers, a couple of hundred kilometers way through. So we're just going to drive down this road and see where it takes us today. On the road again, just can't wait to get on the road again, traveling with...
So we've come about 45 k's along the Congleton Road from the station, and we're at a gate, and we're going to go through the gate. The thing about gates on any farm is that if it's closed, you close it behind you. If it's open, you leave it open. You can can see some friends over there. They're watching. So I'm going to open this gate. And we're going to go follow directions through. So now I've got to close the gate. So we're supposed to be following this trail to the breakaway. Oh, hang on, it turns here, go left. Follow the trail. And we're following these rough directions. So hopefully, we've come through a couple of gates, there's cattle around, and we're gonna get to the breakaway, whatever that is, and find some interesting areas. So awesome. You can almost imagine, this is millions of years old, this country here, these rocks. One time there may have been a river coming down here. And you could just imagine, if you look now, some dinosaurs, diplodocus or giant wombats or something, just going across the plains down there on their way. And you could, we look a bit like this. Just takes you back in time when you see something like this. I love it. Oh my goodness, this is so magnificent. So ancient. This is really cool. Out here in Australia we have the bowerbird. And the bowerbirds, there's different species, and they build this bower, the male builds this bower, which is its dancing circle. It's the place where it attracts the females. It's not a nest, it's just where it does its dancing, attract the females. It's like its bed chamber, if you like. And different bowerbirds are attracted to different colors. This one here is probably the regent bowerbird, which is what we have here in this area. And it likes white things. And you can see it's got a collection of pegs, bottle tops, bits of glass, some berries. And it collects different things of that color. And particularly the white ones, if you're not careful and you leave your ring on the sink while you're washing your dishes, you might find your ring has disappeared. It's even got a bit of blue, some blue bottle tops down here. And it decorates it, builds a bower and hopes to attract the female. Now it's quite interesting that this one is right in the middle of the campsite. And you can see it dances in the middle, puts the sticks in that bower there, dances in the middle and it's decorated. This one's highly decorated. Well, we'll have to see if we can see the bird around. So that's quite amazing, considering we're right here. If you look just over here, is where everybody sits around the campfire at night. And yet, it's built its bower right here.